Hello dear students, today we are going to see from fuels the topic boy's calorimeter. Now already we have seen that we can use the bomb calorimeter to find out the calorific value of the solid and liquid fuels. But see here, if suppose we have the gaseous fuel or a volatile liquid fuel, then it is not useful the bomb calorimeter. And then we need to use the apparatus, another calorimeter known as the Boyle's calorimeter. So here we can say that bomb calorimeter is used to find out the calorific value of solid and liquid fuel. But when we have the volatile liquid or gaseous fuels, we can use the Boyle's calorimeter. So let us start the construction and working of the Boyle's calorimeter. So this is the diagram of Boyle's calorimeter, where we can see that in this we are having the first assembly, that is the gas burner. Then we have this combustion chamber, and then we are having this insulating cover. Okay. And we can see we are having the two thermometers noted as T1, which is present at inlet water, and T2 present at outlet water. And at the same time, we can see that we are having one rubber tube which is collecting the water coming from this calorimeter. One more outlet is there from the insulated cover, which is collecting the condensed steam. So here if you see the gas burner, its function is to carry out the combustion of fuel, where as you can see in this that a gaseous or liquid fuel is being passed through a tubing, and then at the tip of this burner we can carry out its combustion in presence of oxygen, where the flow of gas will be regulated by the meter used, which will regulate the flow of water. The important assembly present for this Boyle's calorimeter is this combustion chamber. Now for this you can imagine one cylindrical container, and to this cylindrical container imagine a tube is being coiled from outside as well as inside. So same is the construction of this combustion chamber, where we can see that we are having a outer copper coiling and inner copper coiling. Means here copper tube is being coiled from this combustion chamber through the outer copper coil as well as through the inner surface known as the inner copper coil. And if you see carefully that what is the function of this copper tubing is to carry out the circulation of water. So here if you see that water will enter from the outer copper coil, and that will be from top of this outer copper coil, moves to the bottom, and then it is given to the inner copper coil, and then it will move in the upward direction, and then it will be collected from this rubber tubing, and that circulated water will be collected in this cylinder. Means we can say that combustion chamber consists of copper coil inside as well as outside, where through these copper coils the water is continuously circulated, which will absorb the heat liberated by the combustion of fuel. And at the same time, to note the temperature of water, at inlet we are having one thermometer and at outlet we are having another thermometer. Now here if you see carefully that again this combustion chamber is being covered up by the insulated cover. Now we have seen in bomb calorimeter that calorimeter is being surrounded by the insulating cover in order to avoid the heat losses which takes place due to radiation. Means what happens here, that when we put the insulating cover, when the combustion of fuel takes place, the heat liberated by fuel should remain inside the calorimeter, and that is why again it is being surrounded by the insulating cover. And to this insulating cover, if you see, we are having one opening which is collecting one more type of water. Now here, if you see, we have seen that when we are carrying out the combustion of a fuel, if the carbon is present, it will convert to CO2, hydrogen convert to water. Now as through this copper coils continuously water is circulated, what happens here, that water formed from the combustion of hydrogen will get condensed, means get cooled, and that will convert into a liquid form, and that will be then collected in this particular container known as the condensed steam. Means condensed steam is nothing but the water formed from the hydrogen of the given type of the fuel. So that is about the construction of Boyle's calorimeter, where we can say we are having one gaseous burner through which we are passing a gas about 5 to 6 liters per minute. Then combustion chamber, where the copper coils are present, through which we are circulating the water. Then insulating cover to detach the assembly from the atmosphere. Two outlets, one is collecting the water circulated through copper coils, another one is the condensed steam, means the water obtained from the hydrogen. And the two thermometers, T1, T2, to note the temperature of inlet and outlet water. Let us start the working of Boyle's calorimeter. So here what is actually done, that we will carry out some warm up period of about 10 to 15 minutes. In this warm up period, what it is done, that first we will carry out the combustion of fuel by passing the gas through the burner. Then we will circulate the water through these copper coils, and we will also collect the water which will be circulated through this copper coil. And in this 10-15 minutes warm up period, we will achieve the three steady conditions, three constant conditions. That is, first one, the constant flow of water, then constant flow of gas, and third, that is the constant temperature of outgoing water. I repeat that we will adjust in warm-up period three steady conditions. First, constant flow of gas, then constant flow of water, and constant temperature of outgoing water. Now once these three conditions are being adjusted or maintained, then we will pass a gas for about 1 minute, and then we will note the following observations. So this is the principle where we can say that the known volume of gaseous fuel sample is burnt in combustion chamber of Boyle's calorimeter. The heat released by combustion of fuel will be circulated, will be absorbed by the water circulating through copper coils in combustion chamber. The mass of cooling water and its rising temperature are being noted. Mass of water produced by condensation of steam, that is also calculated, and from this we can find out the calorific value. So in that 1 or 2 minutes, we will note the following observations. First, that is the volume of fuel burned at STP in given time T will be noted as V meter cube. Then the mass of cooling water circulated in given time, that is capital W, it is in kg. Means that is nothing but the water circulated through the copper coils. Then the temperature of incoming water is T1 degree Celsius. Temperature of outgoing water is T2 degree Celsius. From this we can calculate the rise in temperature, and it will be T2 minus T1. And the last observation which will be noted, that is the mass of steam condensed, means the water obtained from hydrogen, it will be noted as mkg. Now here again we have used the same principle, that is the heat released by combustion of fuel is equal to heat absorbed by water. Suppose we are passing V meter cube of gas and it is liberating the heat as GCV, then heat absorbed by water will be, so weight of water circulated through copper coils is W into the rise in temperature, it is T2 minus T1, into the specific heat of water. Now we know specific heat of water is 1. So we get the equation as V into GCV is equal to W into T2 minus T1. Now why we say the calorific value will be GCV? That here, see, we have assumed that there is no heat loss. Whatever the heat combustion released will be absorbed by the water. And that is why we can say it will be the GCV. Now we want GCV, so we will take that V to the right side of the equation and we will get an equation as GCV is equal to W into T2 minus T1 divided by V, where the unit will be kilocalories per meter cube. Please remember that here we are considering the volumes for gaseous fuel, and that is why it will be per meter cube. Now if we want that in kilojoules, we can multiply it by 4.184. So to calculate the GCV by using Boyle's calorimeter, we can use the equation as capital W into T2 minus T1 divided by V, where capital W is the weight of water circulated through copper coil, T2 minus T1 is rise in temperature, and V, that is volume of water. Now here see, from this experiment we can also calculate the NCV, and we know that GCV and NCV, that will be differing by the content, that is the latent heat of water. And we have collected the condensed steam, that is nothing but the water formed from the hydrogen of the fuel. So we can calculate the latent heat of water or latent heat of steam for per meter cube of sample. So mass of steam condensed is M. When you divide it by the volume, you will get this latent heat for 1 meter cube of gas. Now for example, see, if 10 kg of M is obtained, that is mass of steam condensed is 10 kg, and we are having V, volume of gas burned, as suppose 2 meter cube. Then for 1 meter cube, we can use 10 by 2. So 10 is M, 2 is V, means it is M by V. So for getting the latent heat of water for 1 meter cube, we can use the equation as M by V. And we know that latent heat of water for 1 meter cube, it is 587. So we will get the equation as latent heat of water is equal to M by V into 587. Now how we can calculate the NCV? Let us see. NCV is equal to GCV minus the latent heat of water. And we are having the equation for GCV as W into T2 minus T1 divided by V. And for latent heat of water, right now we have seen it is M by V into 587. So by putting these values of W, that is weight of water circulated through copper coil, T2 minus T1, the rise in temperature of water, V, volume of gas burned, minus the M, that is mass of steam condensed, divided by V, that is volume of gas burned, into 587. When we will solve this, we will get the calorific value in terms of NCV. And again the unit will be kilocalories per meter cube. If we want that in kilojoules, we will multiply it by 4.184. So this is about the construction, working and calculations of the calorific values by using the Boyle's calorimeter. So here we can say Boyle's calorimeter is used for determination of the calorific value of the volatile liquid and gaseous fuels. By using this Boyle's calorimeter, we can find out the gross calorific value, that is GCV, as well as NCV. Thank you.